Okay, hello guys. So, ito na yung request ninyo. Pasensya na kung medyo natagalan kasi I have made my own PowerPoint presentation. So, ang hirap kayang gumawa. Ano? Okay, so I will be using my laptop. Ito yung laptop natin. Okay, and then I will be solving. Kaya using my pen and paper. Kaya naman itong cellphone kulit ang ginamit kong pang video. Ayan. Okay, kapag magsasolve tayo. And then, there goes our... So, pabalik-balik lang. Sana hindi kayo mahilo, ano? Okay. Ayan siya. So, let's start. Probability and counting rules. So, the first thing that we are going to do is to familiarize ourselves. Ano ba ang probability? So, ang probability is the chance of an event occurring. So, ito yung chance na mangyayari ang isang bagay. Halimbawa, the probability or the chance of raining today, okay? The chance of passing your subject or the chance of failing your subject. Yan, the probability of marrying by 2021. Ayan. Okay, so those are probability, okay? So if we say probability experiment, it is a chance process that leads to well-defined results called the outcomes. Ito na yung, hindi ito yung mga probably or yung experiment na ginagawa ninyo sa mga science laboratories. So, these are actually activities, okay, or events, okay, or activities like flipping a coin, tossing a die, okay, flying a kite, ayan, giving a correct answer, winning a game, etc. And if we say outcome, it is the result of a single trial of a probability experiment. So, halimbawa, magtotoss tayo ng coin. Yung isang toss ng coin, okay, kung ano yung lumabas, yun yung outcome na tinatawag. So, example nito ay the possible outcomes in flipping a coin or head and tail. All possible outcomes in tossing a die are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay? So, the sample space is the set of all possible outcomes of a probability experiment. Example, kapag nag-flip tayo ng 2 fair coins, ang mga lalabas ay pwedeng dalawang head, pwedeng yung isa ay head at yung isa ay tail, pwedeng yung isa ay tail, pwedeng yung isa ay head, or dalawang tail. So, those are the possible outcomes. And then, if we're going to write it as a set, then that is our sample space. Okay? Now, in identifying all the sample space all the outcomes for us to be able to write our sample space at para wala kayong ma-miss, you can use the tree diagram. Okay? It is a device consisting of line segments from a starting point and also from the outcome point. So, it is used to determine all possible outcomes of a probability experiment. So, ito yung example natin. Meron tayong dalawang examples dito. So, if you're going to toss a coin 3 times, ayan. So, yung first toss mo, ang lalabas ay maaaring head or tail. Yung second toss mo, kapag head yung lumabas doon sa unang toss, pwede siyang sasamahan ng head or tail pa rin doon sa second toss. Kapag tail naman, head or tail pa rin yung sa second toss. And then, sa third toss, yung head mo sa una, head mo sa pangalawa, pwedeng sasamahan niya ng head din sa pangatlo o kaya tail. Ganun din sa mga susunod. Okay, so ganito ang itsura ng tree diagram. So, head and tail para sa first na toast. And then, mula sa first na outcome, possible outcome, head and tail pa rin. And then, mula sa isang possible outcome naman doon sa second toast mo, head and tail pa rin. So, kapag magsusulat ka na ng outcome mo, head, head, head. So, ayun siya, head, head, head. Then, head, head, tail. So, ayun siya, head, head, tail. And then, head, tail, head. So, head, tail, head. And then, head, tail, tail. Ayan. And then, tail, head, head. Tail, head, head. Tail, head, tail. Ayan. Tail, tail, head. Ayan. And then, tail, tail, tail. Ayan. So, wala kang mamimiss na outcome. Okay? Ganun din dito. For example, you are ordering your lunch. in restaurants. So ito yung mga pagpipilian mo. So the first option that you will have is for your drinks. Ayan. So maaari kang pumili ng soda o kaya juice. And then, bakit walang water? Kasi libre ang water. Okay? And then, para sa iyong bread, pwedeng bagel, rye bread, or white bread. Ayan. Okay, tatlo. And then, para naman sa, ano ito kaya? Para sa side dish, o kaya sa, ano, hindi ko alam yan. Nasa example lang yan. Okay, cheese, pastrami, roast beef, or turkey. So, kapag kinuha mo lahat yung outcome para isulat mo siya sa sample space mo, eto na siya. So, soda, bagel, cheese, soda, bagel, pastrami, soda, bagel, roast beef, ayan. So, ayan na siya lahat. So, magsusulat tayo ng isang example para mas lalo ninyong maintindihan. Okay? So, dito tayo. Halimbawa, plano mo ng mag-asawa at magkaroon ng anak at napag-usapan ninyo ng boyfriend mo o kaya ng mapapangasawa mo na tatlo ang magiging anak ninyo. So, what are all the possible outcomes ng magiging genders or pagkakasunod-sunod ng mga genders ng mga anak ninyo? Okay, so you will have 3 children. Okay. Ganun muna natin siya. Widen natin. So, 3 children. So, this will be the column for your first child, second child, and then the third child. Okay. So, ito yung mga children mo. So, this is our starting point. Napagilid ako ng pagsulat. So, yung first child ninyo ay maaaring boy or girl. Okay? And then, yung second child ninyo, given na yung first child ninyo ay boy, maaari ding boy or girl. Given na yung first baby ninyo ay girl, maaari rin yung first or second baby ninyo ay boy or girl pa rin. Okay? And then, given na yung first baby ninyo ay boy at saka yung second baby ninyo ay boy, pwede rin yung third baby ay boy din o kaya girl. Given na yung first baby ninyo ay boy at saka yung second baby ninyo ay girl, yung third ninyo ay pwedeng boy or girl. Ganon din dito, kapag given yung first na baby ninyo ay girl, pwede rin maging boy pa rin yung, at saka yung girl, dito rin, boy or girl. Ayan. Okay, so tignan na natin lahat yung possible outcomes. Boy, boy, boy. Okay, and then we have boy, boy, girl. And then we have boy, eto, boy. O kaya pag ganun kayo, pwede rin, para hindi kayo malito. Boy, girl, boy. Ayan, hindi. Pero kapag ganyan, ganyan ang pagsulat. Ayan. Okay, and then, girl. Ito na siya. Girl, girl, boy. And then we have boy, boy, girl. And then we have girl, boy, girl. And then we have boy, girl, girl, and girl, girl, girl. Ayan. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, very good. So, ito na yung mga possible na outcomes mo. Pwedeng tatlong lalaki, yung iyong anak. O pwedeng yung panganay mo ay boy, pangalawa mo ay boy, yung bunso mo ay girl. Ganun and so on. So, kapag sinulat mo na yan sa sample space mo, so, ang isusulat natin is yung sample space, okay, ng gender ng inyong mga anak. So, ganito ang pagsulat. Okay, and close mo siya sa bracket. And then, sisimulan mong isulat doon. So, boy, boy, boy. And then, boy, boy, girl. And then, we have boy, girl, boy. And then, we have boy, girl, girl. Then, girl, boy, boy, girl, boy, girl. A girl, 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 and girl, girl, girl. Ay, girl, girl, boy pala yung kanina. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, ayan ang sample space mo. Okay, so I hope that is clear. Let us now proceed to our next slide. Ayan, medyo mahirap ang na-applyan kong trabaho. Okay, and so next. Ayan, kapag sinabi naman nating event, is consists of a set of outcomes of a probability experiment. Okay, halimbawa, ang experiment mo ay flipping a coin. Yung event na gusto mong makuha ay yung outcome na gusto mong makuha, yun ang tinatawag nating event. Okay, so it can be or it can have one outcome or more than one outcome. Example, if a die is rolled and a 6 shows up, this is called an outcome. Okay, and since this event has only one outcome, it is called a simple event. So, simple event ang tawag kapag one possible outcome or one outcome lang ang lalabas sa minsan mong trial. Okay, halimbawa nag-flip ka ng coin at ang lumabas ay head, that is a simple event kasi iisa lang yung lalabas. Okay, or kapag sinabi mong getting a tail when you flip a coin, so isa lang yung ina-expect mong magiging outcome, yung tail lang. So, yun ay simple event. Pero kapag sinabi mong getting an odd number when you toss a die, sa die, merong tatlong odd numbers. Ano yung mga odd numbers na yan? 1, 3, and 5. So, hindi na siya simple event kasi may tatlong possible outcomes ka na. Okay, so, yun yung tinatawag na event. Getting an odd number when tossing a die. So that is an event. Okay? So it is called a compound event since it consists of three outcomes or three simple events. Okay? Next. Ayan na. So these are the three basic interpretations of probability. So these are the three basic interpretations of probability: the classical probability, the empirical or relative probability, or relative frequency probability, and the subjective probability. So I'm going to discuss this one after the other. So let's start with classical probability. Kapag sinabing classical probability, ito yung i-assume mo or i-consider mo na lahat ng outcome dun sa sample space mo are equally likely to occur. Pare-pareho sila ng chance na lumabas. Halimbawa, mamimili ka ng sasagutin mo sa lima mong manliligaw, wala kang bias sa pagpipili. Draw lots na lang, parang ganon. So that is classical probability. Lahat sila equal yung chance na mapili. Okay? So let us have some of our examples. Let's say, find the probability of getting a red ace when a card is drawn is yan at random of an ordinary deck of cards. So, naglalaro ba kayo ng cards? Ako kasi dati kaya hindi ko naintindihan ang probability nung college ako. Nung college ako okay lang kasi yung teacher namin noon, bihira lang siyang gumamit ng mga ganitong examples kasi sa Adventist school din ako nag-aral. Pero noong nagpunta na ako ng MA, masteral, hindi ko na masyadong maintindihan yung mga examples ng teacher ko kasi ito na yung mga ginagamit niya, mga cards. Okay? So, medyo magkakaroon din tayo ng problema kapag hindi ninyo alam ang tungkol sa mga cards. So, first example natin, find the probability of getting a red ace when a card is drawn at random from an ordinary deck of cards. Nandun din sa inyong module ito. Okay? So, with classical probability kasi, sabi ko nga kanina, equally likely events are considered in classical probability. Diba? So, meron tayong formula ngayon sa classical probability, which is the probability of an event is equal to the number of the outcome, okay, the number of the outcome, possible outcome, the number of the possible outcome of the event, and over the number of all the possible outcomes. Ayan. So, dito sa example nating una, red ace daw. Okay, yung alas ang ace. Okay, so ilang alas ba ang nasa deck of cards? Diba, dalawa? Ito ay yung ace of hearts at saka ace of diamonds. Okay, so sa event natin na drawing a red ace, meron tayong dalawang possible outcome ng event natin. Ayan. And then sa sample space natin, ang number naman ng sample space natin ay yung lahat ng number ng cards. Ilan ba yung number ng cards? There are 52 cards in a deck. Okay? So, yung number ng ating possible outcome ng event natin na mag-draw tayo ng red ace ay 2 over yung number ng lahat ng possible outcomes natin, lahat ng pagpipilian natin is 52. Or we can reduce that to 1 over 26. Okay, so this is the probability of drawing an ace. Sabi nila, ang probability daw or ang pinaka application daw ng probability ay gambling. Hindi ko alam kung totoo yan. Dahil kung totoo yan, wala na sanang nagtataya ng betting at saka ng lotto. Kasi kung titingnan mo yung probability ng winning a lotto, million yung possible na outcome. So, isa lang ang tatayan mo doon. So, 1 over millions ang kwan mo, ang chance mo para manalo. Okay? Next example, if a family has 3 children, find the probability that 2 girls of the 3 children, 2 of the 3 children are girls. Okay, ulitin natin, if a family has 3 children, find the probability that 2 of the 3 children are girls. Ayan. So balik tayo doon. Meron na tayo kaninang sample space na ginawa para doon. So 3, 'di ba? 3 children. So ano daw yung probability na dalawa sa mga magiging anak nila ay babae? So titingnan natin yung mga outcomes ng event natin. Okay? So yung number ng event natin and ang event natin ngayon ay, sige, isulat ko muna. Ang event natin ngayon ay 2 among the 3 children are girls. Ayan yung event natin. So, yung number ng event mo ngayon, ay, sorry, hindi pala makita. Ito yung problema ko kapag ganito. Okay, so yun yung event natin. 2 among the 3 children are girls. Okay, so yung number ng event natin, titignan natin dun sa sample space natin. So, ito, dalawang girls. Asan pa? Ito, dalawang girls. Ito ay dalawang girls. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Okay, so yung number ng event natin ay 3. Okay, and then ilan lahat yung nasa sample space natin? Bilangin natin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8. And we have that formula. Therefore, the probability of our event, which is 2 among the children are girls, ay 3 over 8. Ganyan lang siya. Kadali. Okay? So, next. Ayan. Next, we have a card is drawn from an ordinary deck. Find these probabilities. Okay? So, lagyan ko nga ito ng ganyan. So, ang first ay getting a jack. Yung first na event natin, event ay getting a jack. Okay? So, yan yung event natin. So, ilan ba ang jack doon sa ano natin? Sa deck of cards natin. So, meron tayong jack of hearts, jack of diamonds, jack of clubs, at saka jack of clubs, spade. Ayan. So, meron tayong ang N of E natin, or number of events natin ay 4. Kasi meron tayong 4 na jacks. Okay? And then, ang sample space naman natin ay 52. Therefore, the probability of drawing a jack is 4 over 52 or that is equal to 1 over 13. Ayan. Okay, ganun lang siya kadali, guys. I-identify mo lang yung mga possible outcome ng event mo over all the possible outcomes. Okay? And then, letter B natin ay, ang letter B natin, sabi niya, getting a 6 of clubs. 6 of clubs. So, ayung event natin ay, getting a 6 of clubs. So, ilan ba yung 6 of clubs? Iisa lang yan. Kasi 6 of clubs, very specific. So, isa lang yan. So, ang N of number of event natin or number of possible outcomes sa event natin ay 1 over yung sample space natin ay 52 pa rin. So, ang chance nang makukuha natin kapag nag-draw tayo ay 6 of clubs ay 1 over 52. Ayan, okay? So, remember guys that probability can be written in fraction. It can also be written in decimals and in percent or percentage. Okay, so kapag decimals, i-divide mo lang siya. Okay, so magiging decimal na siya. At kapag minultiply mo yung decimal mo by 100, then that will become a percent. Diba? So, tignan natin ito. So, you can say that the probability of getting a 6 of clubs is 1 over 52 or divide natin 1 over 52 equals 0.019, okay? Or 1. I-multiply mo yan ng 100, magiging 1.9%. Ayan. So, meron pa tayong dalawa pala dito. Okay? Ayan. So, naka 22 minutes na tayo. Hindi pa tayo nakakalayo ng ating PowerPoint. Okay, mahaba talaga ito. So, letter C natin ay getting a 3 or a diamond. Ayan. So, meron tayong conjunction ngayon na or. Diba? So, we must be very familiar with these conjunctions. Okay, yung or, yung and. Ayan, yung mga connectives natin. Pero, somehow related din siya sa set theory. Okay? So, titingnan natin. So, getting a 3 or a diamond. So, kapag ang event natin, dalawa. Yung event 1 natin ay getting a 3. Okay? And then, yung event 2 natin ay getting a diamond. Ayan. So, kung titignan natin, dalawa yung events natin. Okay? Pero, i-analyze natin kasi ang sabi niya ay or. Okay? Or. Ibig sabihin, kukunin natin yung event ng E. So, yung number ng possible outcome natin ng makukuha natin ay 3, ay 4, di ba? Kasi meron tayong 3 of diamond, 3 of hearts. Sige, isusulat ko yon. So, ang event 1 natin, 1, para maintindihan ninyong mabuti. Okay, so, ang number ng event 1 natin ay 3. Bakit? Ay, 4 pala, sorry. 4. Kasi meron tayong 3 of diamonds, 3 of hearts, 3 of spade, at 3 of club. Ayan. Okay? So, clubs, spades, diamonds. Okay. So, 4. Diba yung ating possible outcome dun sa first event natin. How about dun sa second event natin? Okay? Ilan kaya yan? 13 siya. Kasi merong 13 na diamonds. Diba? Meron tayong, dun sa diamonds natin, meron tayong 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then we have the king, queen, and jack, at saka ace pala. Ay, ace pala yung 1. Sorry. Ace pala ito. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Ayan. So, yung event. Therefore, yung event end natin. Ay, yung end of event 1 pala natin ay 4 over 52. Okay, 4 over 52. At yung number naman ng event 2 natin ay ilan? Yes, 13 over 52. Okay, but yung isang 3 natin ay kapareho nung isang 3 din natin doon. Kaya dapat tanggalin natin 'yan. So itong 4 natin dito ay magiging 3 over 52 kasi yung 3 natin na isa ay napasama na doon sa diamonds natin. Nakukuha nyo yun? Therefore, kapag kinuha natin yung events or yung probability of getting 3 or diamonds ay 3 pala. 3 over 52. 3 na lang yung 3 kasi napasali yung 3 of diamonds dun sa mga diamonds na. Plus 13 of 52. That is equal to 16 over 50. Sorry. Or 4 over 13. Ayan. Okay. So, I hope that is clear. Kapag hindi nyo siya maintindihan, go back. Sa tingin ko naman, maliwanag na yung pagkaka-define ko. Ano? So, yung 3 ay nakasali na doon sa 3 ng diamond ay nakasali na sa diamond. Kaya binawasan natin yon. Okay? So, pagplasin natin siya kasi or siya. So, ibig sabihin, kapag or yung ginamit nating connective, plus ang ibig sabihin nun. Okay, sa classical probability. And then, the last example. Yung last example natin, sabi niya, getting a 3 or a 6. So, dalawa ulit yung events natin. Yung event 1 natin ay... Event 1. Bakit kasi N ang nisusulat ko? Event 1 natin ay getting a 3. Yung event 2 natin ay getting a 6. Ayan. So, doon sa event 1 natin, ilan yung 3 sa deck of cards? Meron tayong 3 of diamond, 3 of hearts, 3 of spades, and 3 of clubs. So, 4 ulit siya. 4. So, that is 4 over N of S is 52. And then, yung next natin ay 6. Ganun din, 4 din, diba? Okay. Is 6 over 52. Ayan. So, the probability of getting a 3 or 6 ay, ayon, 4 over 52 plus, ay, bakit 6 ang sinulat ko? 4 pala yun, sorry. 4 over 52 which is equal to 8 over 52. Hindi tayo nag-minus ng 1. Bakit? Kasi magkaiba naman sila. Okay? Magkaiba sila. So, this is equal to, reduce natin to sa lowest term, which is equal to, ilan? By 4? 2 over 13. Ayan. Okay? So, I hope... Clear na tayo sa classical probability. Ayan. So, balik tayo sa ating PowerPoint. Okay, next. There are 4 basic probability rules. Okay, what are these? Number 1, the probability of an event E is a number, either a fraction or decimal, or percentage between... And including, or hindi pala, kasi decimal pala yan. So, walang percentage dyan. Okay, between 0 and 1. Kapag percentage naman ang gagamitin natin, it's between 0 and 100%. Okay? So, walang probability na 101% o kaya 1000%. Kaya kapag sinabi ng manliligaw mo na 101% ang pagmamahal niya sa'yo, then he must be lying. Okay? So, hanggang 100 lang talaga. Ayan. So, ang unang rule, sinasabi niya na ang probability ng isang event ay hindi bababa sa 0 at hindi lalagpas sa 1. Okay? Kapag ito ay given na fraction o kaya decimal. Okay? Kaya naman sinasabi natin the probability of getting an ace is 1 over 56 or 4 over 56. Ayan. The probability, so that is not equal to 2 or that is not more than 1. Okay? Number 2, if an event is certain, kung sigurado siyang mangyayari, then the probability of E is 1. Halimbawa, the probability that the sun will shine tomorrow is 1. Okay? Kasi sigurado naman na it will shine tomorrow. Even though, kapag may mga clouds tayo, the sun is still shining beyond those clouds. Okay? The probability that the sun will set today is also 1 since sigurado namang magsiset yung ating araw ngayon. Okay? The probability that everyone will die, okay, it's not 1. Bakit? Kasi sabi sa Bible na there are those who will not die upon the second coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. Okay, meron at meron yung mga makakakita. It's not 1. Okay, kasi hindi siguradong lahat ay mamamatay. Okay, but the probability that your hair will grow long is also 1. Kasi talaga namang humahaba ang ating mga buko. Okay? So, kapag siguradong mangyayari ang isang event, the probability is equal to 1. Okay? Now, if an event cannot occur, okay, the probability is 1. Like, the probability of men conceiving a child is 0. Oh, sorry, that's 0. Ay, clerical error. Sandali nga, i-edit nga natin. Nasaan siya? Ito, i-edit na rin natin. That is off. And then, this is 0. Ano ba yan? Sorry, guys. Ayan. Okay, if an event E cannot occur, its probability is 0. Okay? Just like, as I have said, the probability of a man or a male to conceive a child is 0. Since, wala naman talagang nabubuntis na mga lalaki. Ayan. Ano pa? Ang 0 ang probability. The probability of drawing 9 from tossing a die. Okay, that is also 0 kasi wala namang 9 sa die. Diba? The probability of getting a sum of negative 3 when you toss a die is also 0 since you cannot or 2 dice para kapag nag-toss ka ng die na dalawa or dice na dalawa at kukunin mo yung sum nila and it is negative, that is 0 since that will not happen. Okay? And then the fourth rule is the sum of all the probabilities of the outcomes in sample space is 1. Tignan natin. So gagawa tayo ng computation na magpapakita na ang probability ng all the outcomes in a sample space is equal to 1. Okay, tignan natin dito. So, kukunin natin yung example natin kanina doon sa boy, girl. Okay, oops, bumalik yung aking... Ay, hindi pala. Okay, so ito siya kanina. I-widen natin. Okay, ito siya kanina. So, yung possible outcomes natin kanina ay boy. Let me write it na pahaba. Ay, na vertically. So, boy, and then we have boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, boy, girl, then we have girl, boy, girl. Okay, so kapag titignan natin, lahat ng mga ito, nasa classical pa rin tayo, ano? Lahat ng mga ito, pero kahit hindi classical, basta lahat ng sum ng probabilities ng nasa sample space mo ay dapat equal to 1. So, we have how many outcomes? We have 8 outcomes, di ba? So, ang probability na lahat ng anak mo ay lalaki ay 1 over 8. Kasi 1 out of 8. Sana nakukuha nyo yon. The probability naman na ang panganay mo at saka pangalawa mo ay lalaki at ang pangatlo ay babae ay 1 over 8 pa rin. Isa lang yung ganyang sequence dito sa ating sample space. And the probability na boy-girl-boy yung sequence ng magiging anak mo or gender nila ay 1 over 8 din. So it goes, the list goes on, 1 over 8 lahat yan kasi hindi naman sila magkakapareho. Therefore, if you're going to add all these probabilities, so probability of event ang tawag na dyan. So kapag inad mo ang lahat ng probability na ito, so since pareho sila ng mga denominators, bilangin natin 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that is 8 over 8 or that is equal to 1. Okay? Ngayon naman, magkakaroon tayo ng ibang example. Ano yung probability naman, probability of an event yung probability naman of tossing yung sa pag-toss ng die, ayan, so die tossing a die. Tignan natin kung equal to 1 din lahat yung mga nasa sample space natin. So, kapag tossing a die, ang nasa sample space natin, ang mga possible outcomes ay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Ayan. So, susulat din natin siya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So, yung probability of event na makukuha mo ay 1 ay, di ba, 6 silang lahat. 1 over 6. Okay, kapag 2 naman ay 1 over 6. 1 over 6 pa rin yan. 1 over 6 pa rin. 1 over 6 and 1 over 6. Which is equal to 6 over 6. And that is equal to 1. So, yung probability ng events natin should be equal to 1. Okay? Yung lahat ng nasa sample space natin. Ayan. So, those are the probability rules. So, kapag nagpa-exam ako at tinanong ko ang probability ng isang event at lumampas kayo ng 1 o kaya bumaba kayo ng 0, then your answer is wrong. Okay, it should be less than or equal to 1 but more than or equal to 0. Ayan. Okay, next. So, those are the rules na kailangan ninyong pakatandaan. Next, we have the complementary events. Ang complementary events ay napakahalaga din, lalo na kapag we are dealing with large numbers. Okay? So, later on, you will appreciate the application or the concept of complementary angles kapag malaki-laki yung ating mga numbers at saka yung operations natin. Okay, so ano ba ang complementary events? The complementary of event is the set of outcomes in the sample space that are not included in the outcome of event E. So, it is denoted by E bar. Okay, E bar, ayan. E na may bar sa taas. Okay, E bar ang tawag dyan. So, let us have some examples. Number 1, rolling a die and getting a 4. Okay? So, yung event daw natin, sulat natin. Okay? Yung event daw natin ay rolling a die and getting a 4. Okay, so, ilan yan doon sa ating sample space? Ayan yung tossing a die natin or rolling a die natin. So, ito yung mga sample space natin or yung mga outcomes. Ito yung sample space natin. Ilan ba ang 4 dyan? Okay, isa lang. Over yung ilan silang lahat? 6 silang lahat. So, the event of getting 4 is 1 over 6. Now, kapag sinabing E bar, ito yung mga kasama niya doon sa sample space pero hindi kasama sa event. Okay, so yun ay ang mga 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. So, ilan yung mga kwan nila dyan? Ilan yung probability nila? Tigwa 1-6 sila. Okay? Ibig sabihin, yung N of E natin ay 5 or E bar natin ay 5 at yung sample space pa rin natin ay 6. Therefore, the probability of the complementary event of rolling a die and getting a 4 is 5 over 6. May napapansin ba kayo? O, nag-subtract lang tayo from 1 minus our P of E. Therefore, meron tayong formula for complementary event. Our formula for the probability of our complementary event is equal to the probability of... Ay, sorry. Nag-advance na naman yung ballpen ko. Ay, sorry. Irisin ko yan. Okay, dahil mali yan. Ikaw na ballpen ka kung anong sinusulat mo. Okay, so the probability of the complementary event is 1 minus the probability of E. Okay, so kung makakita natin kanina ay ang probability of our complementary event is equal to 1 minus yung 1-6 kanina. That is equal to 5 over 6. Oh, simple lang, di ba? Okay, next example natin. Ang sabi sa next example natin, ayan, selecting a letter of the alphabet and getting a vowel. Okay, so ilan ba ang letters ng alphabet natin? Ilan ang letters ng alphabet natin, Maya? Ah? Okay, yung sample space natin ay 26. Okay? 26. Eh, ilan yung vowel dun sa 26? Ilan ang vowel sa 26, Maya? Ilan ang vowel sa 26? May zoom daw siya. Okay, so, yung E natin, yung N of E natin ay 5. Kasi meron tayong A, E, I, O, U. Okay? Therefore, ang probability of E natin ay 5 over 26. Okay? How about the probability of our complement? Okay, so ang complement natin ay 1 minus 5 over 26 equals ilan? 26 minus 5 is 21 or 21 over 26. Ayan. So, I hope that is also clear. Vowel ba yung naiano natin? Okay. So, let us have our next example. Our next example is find the complement of selecting a month and getting a month that begins with J. Ayan. So, ilan ba? Ilan ba yung months, ay nang yung months natin in a year? We have 12 months. At ilan sa kanila ang nagsisimula sa J? So, ang N ng probability, ang N of E natin ay getting, or ang event natin ay getting a month that begins with J. So, we have January, February, March, April. So, ito yung J. Sa aking left, ito naman yung... Oops! Ah! Lobot na yung ating laptop. Bakit natanggal ang... Oh, sorry guys, sorry. Ayan. Okay, so ito yung ating J. Ito naman sa right ko yung hindi J. So, January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. Okay, so tatlo yung J natin. Okay, so January, June, and July. Oops, nasaan na siya? Ayan. So, ito yung ating, the probability of our event is 3 over 12, or that is equal to 1/4. Okay? So, yung probability ng complement natin, complementary event natin ay 1 minus 1 fourth, which is equal to 3 fourths. O, ganyan lang siya kadali at hindi na nag-open yung ating laptop. At namatay na rin yung ating... Sorry guys, hindi nakita. Okay, Pasko muna. Ayan, parang may mali ako. Probability yung kinuha natin. Pero ang sinasabi pala dito, find the complement of each event. Even though, okay naman, kasi probability, na-discuss ko na yung probability. Sige, kunin natin yung complement of each event daw. So, yung complement ng rolling a die. So, kapag sinulat natin yan, guys, magiging ganito siya. So, E bar is equal to, or the sample space, paano ba? Okay, sample space of E bar is, ayan. So, yung number 1 kanina, rolling a die and getting a 4. So, 1, 2, 3, 5, and 6. Ayan siya. Okay? And then, the sample, ang haba naman kasi kanina. Okay? Yung number 2, ang sample space ng ating E bar kanina, yung sa consonant at ay sa vowel ay ganito siya. Consonants. Ayan. Okay? And we're done. We had the complementary events and with the probability of complementary events. Okay? So, I hope that is clear. Meron pang isa. So, we have this what we call the rules of complementary events. Okay? So, ano yung mga rules na yun? So, yun yung probability. Yung isa kanina, na-discuss ko na, yung probability of E bar natin or yung probability ng complementary event natin ay 1 minus the probability of our event. We have another one. Our probability of the event is also equal to 1 minus the probability of our complementary event. So, parang yun kanina. So, kung ang hinahanap namin or kung ang given ay yung complementary, makukuha mo pa rin yung probability ng event mo kasi you can subtract the probability of your complementary event from 1. And we also have the probability of our event plus the probability of our complementary event should always be equal to 1. Ayan. So, these are what we call the rules of complementary events. Okay? So, kapag given ang isa sa kanila, you can find the other since we have these formulas. Okay? So, we are done with complementary events. I complement classical probability. Okay, so kapag sinabing classical probability, ito yung lahat ng samples mo ay equally likely to occur. Or ibig sabihin, pare-pareho sila ng probability na mapili or madraw or mangyari. Okay, so let us proceed to the next one, the empirical probability. So, ito yung sinasabi natin na relative frequency probability. Okay, bakit? Kasi it relies on actual experiences to determine the likelihood of outcomes. Okay, so kailangan mo ng actual na gagawin. So, that is empirical. Diba, meron tayong sa research, sabi natin, if you are doing a research, it should be empirical. Okay, dapat na-experience talaga, okay? Or actual na ino-observe mo. Para sa ganon, yung more reliable yung outcome. Okay? So, dito, kapag sinabing empirical probability, dapat actual yung gagawin mo so that you will be able to determine the likelihood of outcomes. Like tossing a coin. Kapag nag-toss ka ng coin, it should not be only once, or do not assume na, parang sinasabi ng empirical na do not assume that one half talaga yung chance na magpapakita ang head o kaya one half yung magpapakita ang tail. Kasi nga naman, kapag nag-toast tayo ng coin ng 10 times, hindi natin sasabihin or hindi natin masasabi na 50% or 5 outcomes will be head And 5 outcomes will be tail. It can be 7/10 or 3/10 or 6/10, di ba? Sana naiintindihan niyo yung ibig kong sabihin. Okay, ganun din kapag nag-roll tayo ng die, hindi kapag 6 na beses tayo nag-roll ng die, hindi palaging magkakasunod na ang lalabas ay 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Ang sinasabi ng empirical, hindi equal na nangyayari yung mga events or ay yung mga probability na nangyayari yung events. Unlike sa classical na lahat sila equal yung magiging chance. Okay? So, yun ang pagkakaiba ng classical at saka ng empirical. Now, let us have examples for empirical probability. It says here, asking 500 children, 500, oops, nako, natanggal na tuloy, mahuhulog na mamaya yung aking cellphone. Huwag ko na siyang gagalawin, ito na lang gagalawin ko. Ayan, asking 500 children from whom do they expect Christmas gifts? So, meron tayong we expect gifts during Christmas, ano? So ngayon merong isang researcher na tinanong yung 500 children kung kanino sila nag-expect ng gifts, either sa mama nila, sa papa nila, sa mga kapatid nila, sa lolo, lola, auntie or uncle. Ayan, so of course kahit 7 yung pagpipilian natin, kapag sa classical, ang chance nila ay 1/7 si lolo, 1/7 si lola, 1/7 si papa, 1/7 si mama, sa kapatid 1/7, kay tito 1/7, kay tita 1/7. Pero dito sa empirical probability, hindi ganon. Maaring yung iba, yung kalahati nun ay mag-expect mula sa mga parents. Okay, so 1/50. Ayan, sige, isulat natin. Okay, halimbawa, ito yung result ng 500. Okay, so 500 yan na children. Oops. Ayan, so 500 yan na children. Halimbawa, 50 ang sa kanila ay nag-expect mula sa lolo. Okay, 25 mula sa kanila nag-expect mula kay tita. 75 mula sa kanila ay nag-expect mula kay tito. Okay, 17 mula sa kanila ay nag-expect mula kay lola. Okay, sige, 117. Mababait ang mga lola eh. 'Di ba? Okay, 150 na rin kay lolo. And then 35 halimbawa mula sa mga siblings. Okay, ilan na yan? Baka magkamali tayo, lalampas tayo ng 500. 1 plus 25 plus 75 plus 117 plus 150 equals... Ne, 507. Sabi ko na eh. Sandali, ulitin natin. Dito na lang. So, 50, let's say 25, let's say 75, let's say 78, and then let's say... sa siblings, sige, 35, let's see, 50 plus 75 plus 78 plus 25 plus 35 equals, okay, minus 500. So, galing kay mama ay 200, okay, mama, and then papa ay 37, barat si papa eh. Ayan. So, halimbawa, ito yung result natin. Okay? Ito yung result. So, this is equal to 500. Therefore, we have here the probabilities of each event. Yung mga nagsabing kay Lolo, ang probability na manggagaling kay Lolo ang kanilang gift ay 50/500 is... gusto ko ng fraction. Okay, 1/1/... sige, 0.1 daw. Sige, 50, diba? 0.1. Ayan. So, 25 divided by 500 is 0.05. And then, 75 divided by 500 is 0.15. 78 divided by 500 is 0.156. Then 35 divided by 500 is 0.07. And then 200 divided by 500, 200 divided by 500 is 0.4. And then 37 divided by 500 is 0.074. Okay, so these are the probabilities na manggagaling sa lolo, tita, tito, lola, siblings, mama, and papa, yung kanilang mga gifts. Okay, tignan natin kung itong lahat ay equal to 1. Okay, tignan natin kung na-meet niya yung rule ng probability that it should be equal to 1. So, we have 0.1 plus 0.05 plus 0.15, sige, plus 0.15 plus 0.156 plus 0.07 plus 0.4 plus 0.074 equals 1. So, ayan. Yan ang sinasabi ng empirical na hindi pare-pareho. Okay? So, maliwanag na ang pagkakaiba ng empirical sa probability. Ano? Okay, let us have our next example. Ayan, at nakalimutan ko na hindi ko na pala gagalawin ito. Mahuhulog ng cellphone ko mamaya. Huwag naman sana, Lord. Okay. Ang hirap talaga nang na-applyan kong trabaho. Okay. So, in our next example, it says here, in a sample of 50 persons, 21 had type O blood. So, meron tayo, ito yung mga events natin. Type ng blood ay, sige, type of blood. I O, and then we have A, and then A, B, and C. Ay, hindi pala. A, B, and B. Okay, so yung type daw ay 50, ay 21 yung O, 22 yung A, and then yung B ay 5, at saka yung type AB ay 2. So that is equal to, is it equal to, yes, it's equal to 50. Ayan. So, ang tinatanong, a person has type O blood. Ayan. So, ano daw yung probability na ang susunod na base, ito ay base dun sa mga nakaraan na nilang test. Okay, halimbawa nasa hospital. Ayan. So, ito ay base dun sa mga nakaraan na nilang test. Itong mga ito. So, meron daw mga unang 50 na nagpa blood type. At ito yung mga lumabas. 21, 22, 2, and 5. Ayan. So, ito yung frequency. Ayan. So, ano naman yung probability of this event? So, kunin na natin dati para hindi na natin kukunin mamaya. So, 21 divided by 50. Ayan. So, 0.42. And then, 22 divided by 50 is 0.44. And then, 2 divided by 50 ay 0.04. And 5 divided by 50 ay 0.1. So, tignan natin kung equal to 1 yan. Plus 0.04 plus 0.44 plus 0.42 equals 1. Ayan. Okay, so ang first na tanong ay, kapag may susunod na magpapa-blood type test, a person has, or that person has type O blood. Ano yung probability na ang susunod ay type O ang blood niya? So, that will be 0.42. Ayan na siya, di ba? Okay. And then letter B, ito yung letter A natin. Letter B, you can find these examples in your book or in your modules, okay? A person has type A or type B. So, dalawa. So, type A plus type B. Ayan. Okay? So, type A plus type B is equal to yung type A ay 0.44 plus yung type B ay 0.01 and that is equal now to, hindi nagkasya, okay, 0.45. Ayan. Okay? And then, type, a person has neither, hindi daw siya type A or type B. Ibig sabihin, hindi siya type A or type B, so maaaring siya ay type O at saka type AB. So yun ang pagplaplasin natin, type, or yung, kung gagamitin naman natin yung complementary event, yun din yun. Okay, so, type A, ganito ang paggamit nung kwan ng complementary event. Okay, type A or a person neither has neither, ayun siya. A person, letter C, a person has neither type A nor type O pala. Type O, sorry. Type O. So kapag plus natin ngayon probability nilang dalawa, that will be type A natin ay 0.44 plus 0.42, so that is 0.86. Kaya yung kanilang complementary ay 1 minus 0.86, that is equal to 0.14. Tama ba? 0.14 ba? Type A and O. So, type, bakit parang mali? 0.14. Tama pala. 0.14. Okay? Kapag pinag-plus mo yung 0.04 plus 0.1, that is 0.14. Okay? And then, the last one, a type does, or a person does not have type AB blood. Okay? So, a person does not have type AB. So, yung type AB natin, the probability of AB natin ay, ang AB natin ay equal to 0.04. So, kukunin na lang natin. O, dito nyo na ma-appreciate yung complementary. Kasi AB, kesa naman pagplaplasin mo lahat yung iba, yung A, yung O, at saka B, i-minus mo na lang siya. Diba? Kasi does not have, sabi niya. So, 1 minus 0.04, that is equal to 0.96. So, I hope that is already clear. Okay na tayo sa empirical. Ayan, let's now have the subjective. Subjective probability. Okay? So, etong subjective probability naman, uses a probability value based on educated guess or estimate, employing opinions and inexact information. So, based siya sa opinion. Okay? So, nagbe-base lang siya sa opinion. Unlike sa empirical na talagang actual experience. So, yung sa empirical, sa kapag ginamit siya sa research, doon siya sa experimental. Pero itong subjective probability, doon naman siya sa descriptive. Or kaya, sa, what do you call this? Perception. Ayan, sa perceptions. Okay? So, yung mga perceive. Ayan. Okay? So, example, the probability of winning of a candidate in a contest is guessed based on a person's experiences. O halimbawa, nanood ka ng contest. Okay? Halimbawa, singing contest. So, nakita mo lahat yung mga contestants o narinig mo na lahat yung mga contestants, napanood mo na silang kumanta. And then, sasabihin mo ay 50% na ang mananalo ay si contestant number 1. 75% naman ang mananalo ay si contestant number 2. Kasi magaling yung boses niya, tapos yung projection niya magaling din. Parang ganon. Okay? And then, example number 2, diagnosis of a doctor. Ayan, kapag nagpa-check up ka sa doctor, tatanungin sa'yo ano ba ang nararamdaman mo. Okay? Sasabihin mo, kasi doc, masakit ang ulo ko, sumasakit ang tiyan ko, tapos hindi ako makahinga, tapos nawawala yung pang-umoy ko. Ay! Sasabihin ng doktor sa'yo, 70% meron kang COVID-19. Di ba? Okay, another one is the probability of an earthquake. Ayan. So, though meron tayong mga pinang-measure ng occurrence ng earthquake or yung lakas ng earthquake natin, someone or a seismologist cannot really predict kung ano yung chances talaga ng earthquake. Okay? So, probability lang ang ginagamit nila. So, yun. Yung sinasabi nila na there is an 80% probability that an earthquake will occur doon daw sa anong tawag nyo doon? Doon sa dinaanan ng fault. Ano yun?
Fault line.
Fault line. Ayan. Okay? So, that is based on their opinions. Okay? And based from some informations in the past which are also inexact. Okay? Inexact. And then, the probability of sales in the future. O, halimbawa ngayon, yung mga businessmen natin, ito yung ginagamit nilang probability. Okay? So, inexact din kasi ang bentahan. Hindi mo naman talaga alam kung kailan ka makakabenta ng marami o kaya kailan ka makakabenta ng konti. Okay, but then subjective probability ang ginagamit kasi meron yung mga thinking ng tao na kapag December, marami yung bibili kasi nga Thanksgiving, maraming maghahanda at maraming magre-regalo. Okay, so subjective. So nag-base sila sa opinion nila, nag-base sila sa feeling nila na sila man din kasi ay maraming binibili kapag month of December. At saka, isa na rin doon kasi nagko-conclude sila na maraming pera sa December kasi bonus time. Ayan, okay? So, yun naman ang pagkakaiba ng subjective probability sa empirical probability. Okay, so I hope that is already clear. Ayan, so let us proceed to addition rule for probability. Okay? So, kapag sinabi nating rule for probability, meron lang tayong dalawang, aside from our first set rules, meron tayong dalawa. We have the addition and the multiplication lang. Okay? So, although ina-apply din natin ang subtraction doon sa complementary, okay, but then, this addition rule for probability refers to the events, okay, ng probability natin. Or ng, what do you call this? Yun, probability natin. Okay, so mutually exclusive events are two events which cannot occur at the same time. So, napakalagang malaman ninyo kung ang mga events ay mutually exclusive. Okay? Kapag sinabi nating mutually exclusive, yung unang event ay hindi makakaapekto doon sa pangalawang event. Okay? Halimbawa, may dalawa tayong events. Okay? Halimbawa, eto na. Determine which events are mutually exclusive and which are not when a single die is rolled. Kapag nag-roll daw tayo ng isang die, getting an odd number and getting an even number. So, meron tayong dalawang events dito. The first event is getting... Sandali, palakihin natin. Hindi niya ito nakikita. Ayan. Getting an odd number. So, ano yung mga events na yon? Tignan natin yung sample. Makikita nyo siya sa sample space ng event. Ay, hindi. Anong sample space? Doon sa set ng events ninyo or set ng outcome ng event. Sorry. Set ng outcome ng event. So, yung unang event natin, first event natin, event 1 natin ay Getting an odd number, ano yung mga yon? Yung odd number ay 1, 3, and 5. Yan yung mga possible na outcome ng first event natin. And then yung second event natin, event 2, ay getting an even number. So 2, 4, and 6. Ayan naman yung ating second event. So kung mapapansin ninyo, hindi maaapektuhan yung first event natin doon sa second event natin kasi wala silang parehong outcome. Okay, yun ang ibig sabihin. Okay, wala silang parehong outcome. So this is a mutually exclusive event. Or these are mutually exclusive events kasi dalawa sila. Okay, so ganun ang pag-identify if they are mutually exclusive events. Number two, getting a 3 and getting an odd number. So yung getting a 3, isa lang yung outcome niya. Simple event siya kasi 3 lang siya, diba? Pero kapag sinabing, bakit naging malabo ang aking paningin? Ayan. Pero kapag sinabing getting an odd number, tatlo siya. Ito siya, 1, 3, and 5. So, meron ba silang magkaparehong event or outcome? Yes, yung 3 mismo yung kapareho nilang outcome. Therefore, this is not mutually exclusive events. Okay? Then next, getting an odd number and getting a number less than 4. Getting an odd number. So, ito yung mga odd numbers natin ulit. And getting a number less than 4. Meron ba tayong mga numbers dito na less than 4? Yes. Therefore, hindi rin siya mutually exclusive. And then, next, getting a number greater than 4 and getting a number less than 4. Okay, so ito yung mga, yung first event natin, ano yung mga outcomes natin dito? 1, 2, 3. Okay, and ito pala ay 5 and 6. And then dito naman ay 1, 2, 3. Therefore, it is a mutually exclusive or these are mutually exclusive events. Okay? Next, determine which events are mutually exclusive and which are not. When a single card is drawn from a deck. So, getting a 7 and getting a jack. Magkaiba ba yung 7 at saka jack? Yes. Therefore, they are mutually exclusive. Okay, next. Getting a club and getting a king. Doon sa club, may king siya. Diba? So, sa set ng club, meron din siyang king. Therefore, it is not mutually exclusive. Kasi doon sa club, may king. And then, getting a face and getting an ace. Meron bang face doon sa ace? Papa! Busy. Walang face doon sa ace. Kasi kapag ace, isa lang. Isang heart, isang diamond, di ba? Wala siyang face. Therefore, mutually exclusive events sila. And then number 4, getting a face and getting a spade. Doon sa spade, may tatlong faces. Yung king, jack, and queen. Kaya naman, this is not mutually exclusive. Ibig sabihin, kapag doon sa first event mo, ay may outcome na kapareha doon sa second event mo, then they are not mutually exclusive event. Pero kapag walang magkaparehong outcomes, then they are mutually exclusive events. So, I hope that is clear because it is very important in the addition rule of probability. Okay, so ito na yung addition rules for probability. Bakit rules? Kasi meron yatang dalawa. Okay, so number one is the probability of A or B. Yan, so nasimulan na natin ito kanina doon sa pag-discuss ng tatlong representations ng probability, di ba? Okay, so the probability of event A or B. So, that will be equal to the probability of A plus the probability, that is if and only if A and B are mutually exclusive events. Okay? So, napag-aralan naman na natin kung ano yung mutually exclusive events. So, number one, a box contains 3 glazed donuts. Sulat natin yan. 4 jelly donuts and 5 chocolate donuts. If a person selects a donut at random, find the probability that is either a glazed donut or a chocolate donut. Ayan. So, ay, naiiwalay na siya. I-pause natin, guys, at idikit ko lang siya. Okay, guys, ikakat ko siya dito. Okay, and then itutuloy ko siya sa isang video kasi natanggal yung ating holder. Ayan siya, natanggal siya. So, ikakabit ko lang siya sandali. Okay, so i-upload ko na ito para mapanood nyo na. And then, yung susunod, isusunod ko agad.